This circuit consists of a speaker, so you can hear the sounds when they're made, battery for power. If we were to hook the circuit up to itself with no resistor, you'll get that constant frequency. So if we disconnect the circuit, we could hook it to another resistor. So in the case of water, it's a variable resistor. This circuit sends electrons through the blue alligator clip and creates that wave that makes a sound. Well, what else is a resistor? Well, the whole world is a resistor.
So I'll just start. I'm Jay Silver, and what we're gonna talk about today and work with today is that the world that we live in, meaning cats, grandmas, rain, your computer, your shoes, everything in the world, is a construction kit.
It's like the whole education system is locked down from some ancient, 100-year-old idea, except for kindergarten. The very word itself literally means child garden. It means create an environment where people can mess about.
We're going to forget that cans are for holding food, and we're gonna make cans and everything else here do something else. We're gonna give them our own purpose. And so the first really quick exercise, each group is gonna grab some junk and we're gonna make some geometric shape.
The way kindergarten was designed was a set of what we would call toys. So blocks, finger paint, certain geometrical shapes and hoops. These things help children at the appropriate developmental stage of 5 or 6 relate ideas. What's the appropriate developmental tools or toys for a 13-year-old to learn, share, iterate, flourish, mess up, get excited?
I have a merit triangle.
A leaning tower of flowers.
So you call it blocks?
Yeah.
Great. I want someone as soon as possible to have a successful experience with something open-ended so that they can look back and say to themselves, I have accomplished whatever it is we're trying to get.
If I touch one side of the circuit and then the other side, it squeaks, okay? And if I touch it harder, it squeaks higher, and if I touch it less, it squeaks lower. Let's make a little instrument out of this. The simplest instrument you can make is with 2 people. So
the way I believe people learn is by carrying out their own processes in the physical world.
So hold her hand. Now, yeah, there you go. And now hold tighter. There you go. Yep.
I'm only going to teach people by creating a situation where people can then carry out meaningful projects. Let's show how you can invent with a circuit like this. Let's take a piece of string. This is just regular yarn. We can dope the string with a certain type of conductive material, in this case, water, so I just dip the string in water. I can even get vibrato. Leaves could be like buttons. Everyday objects are in a class of their own. And in a sense, anything can be cast as an everyday object. But the important thing about everyday objects is that people have familiarity with them.
What you do with the Makey Makey is you take junk, you hook it up to your computer, and you can control your computer with the junk. So let me show you a little more about that.
But my windows, my house, my relationships with people, that's how inventors think. That's how artists who push the limit think. It's the same as how scientists make new discoveries. Scientists don't think of the scientific method. They're trying to push what's possible.
So I'm gonna start by taking a piece of some tofu that I was just eating. Oh, actually I ate all the tofu. I'll have to take the cornbread. So you hook up the cornbread to one of these 4 buttons or one of these spacer clicks. So I'm touching the cornbread, the video starts. I touch it again, the video stops.
If you take everyday supermarket stuff and you give a catalyst, in this case, electronic duct tape, like a Makey Makey, you have just changed technology, changed everyday objects, and now you have changed yourself because you have this creative confidence that comes from this experience.
Over the next 90 minutes, we're gonna work towards making an invention. You're gonna make, stairs into a piano, or you're gonna make your bench into a Pac-Man controller, or you're gonna take a book, and when you open it, it's gonna send an email. Something's gonna happen when you touch something.
You might ask, is this about making a scientist, or is this about making someone who's resourceful and can address problems in multiple ways? And well, I don't think there's any difference between those 2 questions.
What are you guys working with over here?
Having trouble making it work.
Oh, What kind of troubles?
I think people have the wrong idea of what scientists do. A scientist is a resourceful person who keeps attacking problems and fails 99 times out of 100.
It's like a bird. Since I'm playing Flappy Bird, it's like a bird.
I see there's two people playing at the same time.
Mash it once.
Hello! I'm Mr. Dante. You're the good to me.
I got more.
This is up, this is right, this is left, and this is down. We go Dance Dance Revolution. I'm not that good, so don't laugh at me.
If a kid comes to you with a question, to assume that you have the answer is to assume that life is really simple, but it's not true. If a little kid comes to you and asks you why is the sky blue, you may know something about scattering of light. You may think you know that it reflects off the ocean, but all of that doesn't matter. The point is, it's about the process of them being curious. So don't try to give them answers, try to give them curiosity. So when someone says, why is the sky blue? You say, I wonder why. It's a really multifaceted thing. I wonder why.